With Australia's honeybee population under serious threat from the invasive varroa mite, officials are moving from an eradication strategy to simply managing the spread. It's expected to have a widespread impact on our agricultural sector, but local honey producers are vowing to do what they can to slow the inevitable.
For the Robigs, honey production is a family affair. They're hoping varroa mite won't reach Queensland, but are mindful it's probably a matter of time.
It's quite intimidating to think that one little pest, such as the varroa mite, can come and wipe out an entire industry.
They've built their decade-old business in Logan from the ground up, producing honey from rescued rogue hives and colonies, turning it into award-winning produce.
We have basically a nursery where we'll rehabilitate those bees, make sure they're not diseased, make sure they're not carrying varroa mite.
The parasitic mite was first detected in Australia in Newcastle last year. It's spread to at least 7 locations across New South Wales in less than 18 months. Since the first detection last year, authorities have destroyed tens of thousands of hives. Despite all efforts, the mite is still on the move.
Oh, millions of bees have been destroyed.
Queensland is restricting the transport of bee-related material across the border. It comes as biosecurity officers move from eradicating the pest to simply managing its spread.
If you just leave bee colonies out there now and you're not looking after them, they will probably die. They're probably only around 3% of the population of bees out there will be able to make it through without any human intervention once these mites get into colonies.
As it does spread, it's expected to impact fruit and vegetable production by hindering pollination. The speed of the spread will come down to the vigilance of hobbyists and commercial producers.
Because if we can manage it now, it's going to stop a more serious incursion in the future.
Josh Bavis, Nine News.